Hi, my name is Marya Sabir, and I'm a graduate student at the National Institutes of Health. The growing prevalence of neurodegenerative diseases has positioned these disorders as a leading public health concern. However, despite advancements in sequencing technologies and computational tools, much of the genetic risk underlying neurodegeneration remains to be understood. Moreover, the mechanisms by which these genetic risk factors lead to disease need to be uncovered. Large population studies of Parkinson's disease has identified SLC17A5 as a genetic risk factor in PD patients. However, approximately 20 years earlier, this was first discovered as the cause of a rare neurodegenerative disease called free sialic acid storage disorder, or FSASD for short. SLC17A5 encodes a lysosomal transmembrane transporter that allows a molecule called free sialic acid to be exported from the lysosome into the cytosol. But how this specific gene leads to a neurodegenerative phenotype is still a question. And we asked, can we learn about SLC17A5 by developing and characterizing a mouse model of FSASD? And thus, we developed a mouse model carrying one of the most common mutations within the FSASD patient community. We next tested free sialic acid within the urine and serum, and we can see that in mutant mice, it is elevated. This tells us that this is a bona fide model for FSASD. Next, we performed behavioral testing using the rotor rod, and we can see that mutant mice have poor motor performance and coordination, which resembles human patients. And strikingly, in mutant mice, we have a complete loss of corpus callosum myelination when compared to wild-type littermates. And thus, we've learned that free sialic acid builds up within the lysosome, but how this leads to the development and processing of myelin remains to be understood. In addition, how this leads to the death of neurons remains to be understood as well. And thus, our future studies are focused on assessing optimal lysosomal homeostasis, its role in myelin, in addition to neuronal loss. And while FSASD is a rare disorder, there are approximately 70 other lysosomal storage disorders, most of which present with a neurodegenerative phenotype. And while studying FSASD can help us develop potential therapies for these patients, we may also be able to help patients living with similar diseases. Thank you.